assets.
I got another guy that's.
He didn't say it. Did you ask him?
And in your well-beloved Son, King of kings and Lord of lords. Mercifully grant that the peoples of the earth, divided and enslaved by sin, may be freed and brought together under his most gracious rule, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the lessons.
A reading from Ezekiel, chapter 34. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will search for my sheep and will seek them out. As shepherds seek out their flocks when they are among their scattered sheep, so I will seek out my sheep. I will rescue them from all the places to which they have been scattered on the day of clouds and darkness. I will bring them out from the peoples and gather them from their countries and will bring them into their own land, and I will feed them on the mountains of Israel by the watercourses and in all the inhabited parts of the land. I will feed them with good pasture, and the mountain heights of Israel shall be their pasture. There they shall lie down in good grazing land, and they shall feed on rich pasture of the mountains of Israel. I myself will be the shepherd of my sheep. And I will make them lie down, says the Lord God. I will seek the lost, and I will bring back the strayed, and I will bind up the injured, and I will strengthen the weak, but the fat and the strong I will destroy. I will feed them with justice. Therefore, says the Lord God to them, I myself will judge between the fat sheep and the lean sheep, because you pushed with your flank and your shoulder and butted at all the weak animals with your horns until you scattered them far and wide. I will save my flock, and they shall no longer be ravaged, and I will judge between the sheep and the sheep. I will set up over them one shepherd, my servant David, and he shall feed them. He shall feed them and be their shepherd. And I, the Lord, will be their God. And my servant David shall be prince among them. I, the Lord, have spoken. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Won't you pray with me the words of Psalm 100? Be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Know this, the Lord himself is God. He himself has made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter the gates with thanksgiving. Go into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and call upon his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. And his faithfulness endures from age to age.
A reading from Ephesians chapter 1. I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love toward all the saints, and for this reason I do not cease to give thanks for you as I remember you in my prayers. I pray pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you, what are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe, according to the working of his great power. God put this power to work in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but in the age to come. And he has put all things under his feet, and has made him the head over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Christ.
Jesus said, "When the Son of Man comes into his glory and all the angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people one from another as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he will put the sheep at his right hand and the goats at the left. Then the king will say to those on his right hand, 'Come, you that are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked and you gave me clothing. I was sick and you took care of me. I was in prison and you visited me.' Then the righteous will answer him, 'Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? And when was it that we saw you sick and in prison and visited you?' And the king will answer them, 'Truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it to me.' Then he will say to those on his left hand, 'You that are accursed, depart from me into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry and you gave me no food. I was thirsty and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger and you did not welcome me. Naked and you did not give me clothing. Sick and in prison and you did not visit me.' Then they also will answer, 'Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or sick or in prison and did not take care of you?' And he will answer them, 'Truly, I tell you, just as you did not do it to the one of the least of these, you did not do it to me.' And these will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous into eternal life." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated and good morning. Thank you so much for being here today and for joining us online as well. The gentleman who just read the gospel was my deacon in Palatine. He is still the deacon there. If you look deacon up in the dictionary, I think you would find his picture. Dan is an amazing deacon, an even better friend. I would not have made it through some of the real problems in my life had it not been for his love, his prayer, his wisdom. And so I just invite you to hear a little bit about Dan's ministry. After the service and coffee hour, I'll do some Q&A with Dan about diaconal ministry. What is it to be a deacon? Why is his scope different from mine? And we'll talk a little bit about that stuff at coffee hour. So please do join us. Deacon Dan here.
Thank you, Father Jim, for inviting me here today. And it is an honor to be here. And hello to all of you. And I really have to say, I really miss being with Father Jim. We were at one time had two services, and at the early one, right one, and then we'd go down and drink coffee and talk deep theological things, you know, or talk about the White Sox and the Cubs or something,
and lament.
Yeah, wait till next year. And so I think it's I hope you are celebrating his presence with you at this place. That's great. Like he said, I'm a deacon in the Diocese of Chicago, and I've been one since 2007. In fact, I was so excited to be ordained as a deacon. I got a vanity plate, I know, vanity, ego. But I got a vanity license plate for my car, and it says DCN-DAN, right? And I wanted everyone to know that Deacon Dan was driving this car. I showed it to my nephew one day, and he said to me, Uncle Danny, that's what my family called me, Danny, since I was. And he said, Uncle Danny, does that stand for Dancing Danny? He didn't quite get what I was trying to say or what I was going for. And this is how I felt when I read the gospel reading for today. I didn't quite get it. Oh, I get the part where Jesus will be standing or sitting on the throne of his glory, and all the nations will be gathered before him. I get that part. Okay. And when he separates people one from another, but then he starts talking about sheep and goats, separating the sheep from the goats. Now, I've never been what you could call a country boy. I have not been around sheep or goats much. Oh, I had an uncle who had a farm downstate, and I would go out there in the summers, but the only thing I did was pull potatoes all day long. I didn't care for that much, but no sheep or goats. So I went on a search to understand why Matthew used this comparison of separating people from one another to separating sheep from goats. Now, Scripture, and I checked this out, has ample references to what the characteristics of a sheep are. We heard quite a bit today. But there was not much on the character of a goat. Goats are mentioned a lot in the Old Testament, but it's mainly how to sacrifice them, how to deal with them, not really what they're all about. But I could not find anything on why a goat so needed to be separated. Now, sheep, they're social animals, and they're known to be gentle. That's the great thing about sheep. They're timid and independent. And they are one of the first animals to be domesticated for agricultural purposes. Sheep are raised for their milk and meat and fleece. And sheep's wool is the most widely used animal fiber. I thought that was interesting. And Jesus' relationship with the sheep, he called himself the Good Shepherd. And the sheep knows the voice of the Good Shepherd. The Good Shepherd will leave the 99 sheep that are saved to find the one lost sheep. He found me. There is an implied connection between the sheep and the good shepherd. This is what I see Matthew is saying here. Now, there's no mention that goats have that same kind of connection with the good shepherd. It's never mentioned. And I find that goats are known to communicate with each other by bleating. We know what kind of racket that is, don't we? Goats demonstrate dominance by lowering their heads and pointing their horns at the subordinate animals. Goats explore what's available to find the food that is the best for them, their nutritional value. They can get jealous and aggressive if one goat is favored over another. Abnormal repetition behaviors in goats may include crib biting, over aggravation, and an excessive rubbing and biting of self and others. That doesn't sound so great, does it, to be a goat? And they sound like, to me, that these goats are very self-absorbed and involved in only themselves. But I thought about this separating of sheep and goat, and I could not help but relate it to my journey to the diaconate. Because Matthew is really relating a story of discernment. I don't know if you've heard it put it that way. And what is discernment? To discern. Jesus will be discerning which person is a sheep or a goat. I've had experience of my own set of discernments in my life. In 2003, the priest at St. Martin's Church, Father Bob Settmeyer in Des Plaines, approached me about ordained ministry. Now, I had been very active in the church at that time. I lived in Dayton, Ohio, and we came to St. Martin's in October of 1999. Now, just 3 months later, January 2000, I was asked to serve on the vestry. I was on the vestry for 6 years. And it was in 2003 I applied through the diocese to pursue formation as a deacon. The first thing I had to do was form a committee to help me discern what kind of person I am. Am I a sheep or a goat? At least that's what my discernment group was discerning about me. And after a year of discernment, they submitted their report to the vestry. And the vestry voted to pass on the report to the Committee on Ministry. This allowed me just to go into the formation process. And after 3 years of formation, I was interviewed by the standing committee. That was scary. They too were discerning if I was a sheep or I was a goat. Then they passed their report on to the bishop. It was Bishop Purcell at that time. He interviewed me and did his own discernment if I was a sheep or a goat. Through all of that, I was ordained on February 7, 2007 at St. James Cathedral by Bishop Purcell. And for me, I knew at that time that I was certified, I am not a goat. But how do we know if we are a goat or a sheep? Matthew lays it out for us. Jesus said, and we heard, "For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you gave me clothing. I was sick, and you took care of me. I was in prison, and you visited me." And when have we done that? When we have done that, we have done that for Christ. Well, Jesus has this covered. Matthew continues, "And the king will answer them, 'Truly, I tell you, just as you do it for one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it for me.'" I don't know how you feel about that phrase, but for me, how awesome is that? When we sit with someone who has lost a member of their family, we are sitting with Jesus. When we provide food for someone who does not have any food, we are feeding Jesus. When we welcome the other without judgment, we are welcoming Jesus. When we pray with and pray for someone who is having problems in their life, we are praying with and for Jesus. Just sit with that for a moment. Just imagine. The priest that I had in Dayton, Ohio, asked a question once. And this is way before I even thought of formation of any kind. He says, what if Jesus knocked on your door? What would you do? And I wasn't too proud of where I was or what I was doing or what I was about at that time. And I said, well, I'll go hide. And he looked at me, why would you do that? Now, they ask those questions online, those things that we respond to that make sure we're really us. One of the questions is, who would you like to have supper with? And I always answer, Jesus. That's where I've come, from running away to being with Jesus. So each one of us are called. Yes, we all have a calling. To look within ourselves and to ask the discerning questions. Am I a sheep? Have we heard the good shepherd? Do we follow the good shepherd? Do we do what the good shepherd tells us to do? Do we help others who are in need? Do we think of the other first? Or are we a goat? We ask ourselves, do we not listen to the good shepherd? Do we not follow the good shepherd? Do we not do what the good shepherd tells us to do? And most importantly, do we not help those who are in need? As a goat would do. Do we think of ourselves first without even thinking of the other? I admit, these are hard questions. But this is a hard piece of scripture. But it is an important piece of scripture. And these are important questions we need to ask ourselves, because it not only affects what we do and how we are in this life, but as Matthew tells us, these questions affect us when Jesus comes into his glory. So, are we in or are we out? In the name of one who creates me, the one who sustains and the one who nourishes me.
Amen. Thank you, Deacon Dale. Standing.
Let's proclaim our faith with the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God,
the Father of all Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, your Lord, who proceeds.
Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That they all may be one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake. Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let thy light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come share in your healing.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
In this moment, I invite you to lift your concerns and cares, names of your loved ones, either silently or aloud. Almighty God, we pray for those who travel this weekend and ask you to keep them safe. We pray for those who maintain our roads. Protect them, keep them safe. We lift up the family of former First Lady Rosalynn Carter and ask you to comfort them. We pray for peace in the world, the Middle East, the Ukraine, and Africa, and on our own streets. And all this we ask in the name of the one who loves us more than we can ask or think or imagine, even Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor.
Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have not done. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
Are there any birthdays today? The peace of the Lord be always with you.
I think there's somebody up there.
Oh, that's right. See, now, when you get to 58, you want to kind of forget. Deacon Dan, would you be so kind as to give me a birthday blessing? And if I burst into flames...
Is there
I don't know. Have you heard from Dana? No, she's smart. Yeah, I know. It's kind of like a pneumonia. It is absolutely. Peace. Thank you. Blessings. 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 Peace, brother. If a candidate for holy orders is a sheep or a goat, my panel decided I was a turkey. So I don't know where that falls on the theological spectrum, but there you have it. Lisa.
I wanted to give everybody an update on our pledge drive. We now have $161,440 in pledges, so thank you all. It's not quite our $175,000, but this is the highest pledges we've received in a very, very long time. So great job, everybody. Thank you so much for your commitment to Calvary. And the second thing is, guess what next week is? It's our cookie walk on Saturday during the Jingle Bell Jubilee at 4 o'clock. You can drop off cookies either by contacting Jennifer for a Friday appointment or coming between 12 and 2 on Saturday. There will be people here then setting up if you'd like to help. Please come join us. It's a very good time. And the cookies are delicious, so don't forget to come and purchase your cookies. Thank you.
Lisa, I want to ask a question. I'm totally new to the whole cookie walk concept. Are there other churches that have their own thing the same night?
Yes.
And what happens? People just walk from church to church? Or?
Yes. They have a trolley that goes through town. They will light the park. The whole park will be lit up with Christmas lights, and that's at 5:30. That's usually the kickoff. The Historical Society next door is having, they'll have something there. First Church is having, I believe, carolers or something going on there. They're in this parking lot here. This year's new. They're going to have a Christmas market,
okay.
Which we think will draw people towards us since our walkway will be lit up to our doors over here. And it is our biggest fundraiser of the year, so we hope to welcome many. So
I'm told hundreds of people come through, and so if you come to get your cookies, hang around for a while and introduce yourself to folks and let them know Calvary's a great place and they can find a home here if they don't have one already. Yes. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Carol.
I'm back talking about Revive. There's a cheat sheet back in the back of the narthex showing what people have already chosen to get for these families. So we would really appreciate it if we can get more response and help these families have a Merry Christmas. It would be greatly appreciated. And then the cookie walk. I don't know how many of the pay it forward cards are in the back in the narthex, but maybe we can put one of those pay it forward cards in with the cookies when they pick them up. And have people get them, and maybe that will draw some people back over here too. So please, let's get our Calvary up and running again. We really, really, really have a great place to worship, and we want other people to know about it. And this gentleman right here, he is phenomenal with us, and we need to get rolling here, guys. Thank you.
You are very, very kind. And thank you all for your remembrances and best wishes and prayers. So grateful for that. Other announcements this morning? All right. Let's walk in love because Christ loved us. He gave himself for us and offered him a sacrifice. Everywhere, give thanks to you, Father Almighty, through Jesus Christ our Lord. who on the first day of the week overcame death of the grave, by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of life everlasting. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my body, this is my blood, the new covenant, shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Calling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people, body, and the blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, give us a stay in the right hand, and bring us our presence. Christ, peace and bread from heaven.
Service of worship concludes at the bottom of page 17, and we offer this prayer in unison. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son, and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. The blessing of God Almighty, Father,
Father, Son, Holy Spirit be with you and pursue you all the days of your life.
Amen.
My sisters and brothers, our worship has ended. However, our service in the world continues, so go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And just so you all know, I often close and dismiss with that exact dismissal. I stole it from the church. Join us for coffee hour.